What about the victim and the victim's families? Not the murderer's families. What about the victim's families? I mean, you know, who's advocating for them? I mean, what do we... I mean, I'm at a loss. I'm flabbergasted.
In 1989, James Gibson was accused of murdering two people during a botched armed robbery of an insurance agent in Inglewood. He was convicted and sentenced to life in prison. But even back then, prosecutors wrote in a memo seeking the death penalty that the only evidence against him was circumstantial. During the last 7 years, he's been fighting for a new trial, claiming former Chicago police commander John Burge tortured him into confessing. The Illinois appellate court found he was tortured and they vacated his guilty sentence. He could now face a new trial. Today, the judge said he is aware of the history of this case, but special prosecutors have not shown enough evidence to hold him in jail. They have no eyewitnesses and no physical evidence. And so if he can come up with $2,000, he will be a free man. His family says it's a long time coming.
To God be the glory for the things that he has done in our lives. The 30 years that we have been waiting for this day. If my mother could only be here, because she knew at the beginning that her child was innocent.
My prayers go out to the other families who were involved, because we knew the insurance man. He gave me candy. He gave me dollars to go to the candy store. He would chat with me and my siblings, and he was very nice. It's been a long ride for a lot of people. And I regret to say that the CPD in this matter, they dropped the ball and they messed up when they tortured someone that was not a part of it.
Now, if Gibson is convicted a second time, he faces a mandatory life sentence. Prosecutors, though, could still decide not to pursue this case if they feel like they just don't have enough evidence 30 years later. They will make that decision later in the month of April. The family of the victims here, they say they were at the first trial. They plan to be at the second trial, but they just do not know how much more they can take.